All right, everyone, we're back again. We're ready to see how the execution plays itself out. So let's jump right into this. Well, of course, first we're going to have the life story as usual, I'm sure. And I am curious to see how this ends up going. Was there ever a sister, or was he always just schizophrenic or whatever?
Let's find out.
Wow, seriously? You're correct again.
Absolutely right!
Amazing! This is the third correct verdict in a row.
All right!
If you manage to get 12 correct verdicts in a row, you'll proceed to the bonus round.
I don't think there'll be anyone left.
Hey? How's this gonna last that long?
Oh no. It's gonna happen with Monodam.
No.
Not yet. I haven't heard his answer yet. Kyo, why? Why did you kill Angie and Tenko?
I'm curious too to hear what their motive was. I mean, was he just trying to get out, or was there something else to it?
Right.
Yeah, he no need to kill them both, no matter what motive he have.
No.
Motive?
Hey!
Maybe it was just for fun.
Did your motive have something to do with the transfer student who was resurrected? Even if it did, though, how did that trigger a murder?
Hey, hey!
Don't tell me! Were you actually scared of the resurrection ritual, Kaito?
Shut up!
Yeah, I never said I was scared! The resurrection ritual had nothing to do with it. Nothing to do with it? Because we're friends, I'll tell you, I never once believed in the ritual. I would never kill someone over such a silly thing as that.
What?
So it has nothing to do with the motive.
Yeah.
Then why?
Yes.
For the one that I love.
There is someone that I love.
Sister. From the bottom of my heart. Someone so dear. Someone I long for.
Oh, dear God.
My heart. And she loves me with all her heart.
This is so creepy.
Is he a Lannister?
We vowed an endless love to each other, forever bound by fate.
I think they pretty much directly ripped off of that like one Resident Evil game that I was mentioning. Was it Code Veronica?
None.
I think so.
Because that's exactly how it was. There was like this guy and his sister love. And they were in love.
Mm-hmm.
And then she died and he started masquerading as her.
So creepy.
No matter what anyone says.
What?
Plus they did have a Resident Evil reference before. Remember the crank or whatever?
Oh yeah. Bragging about your perfect love life? Fuck you. Some of us aren't that lucky.
So to see this lover of yours, you had to escape.
Don't tell me.
That's why you killed Angie and Tenko? But why did you need to kill both?
I guess he was committed to his second murder, the one they actually planned? If you asked if I did it to escape this place, my answer would be no.
Wonderful.
Because I have no need to escape this place, the one I love is inside.
Of course.
Inside?
Wait!
Don't look at me! I'm not his lover!
Miu. Calm down. No one would want a disgusting shit-stuffed bitch like you anyway.
Kersploosh!
What the what?
Kersploosh. Hey. Wow. How disturbing. Kyo, who is it? Who is this person you love?
Hey.
Is it really one of us?
When I say inside, I do not mean inside this academy.
You see.
I mean inside me. Right. I figured this is where this is going. Yes, the one I love lives inside me. My dear sister.
Huh?
Sister?
Don't look at me! I'm not his sister!
We know, Miu.
Right?
Well, duh. If he were his sister, he would have killed himself already.
Wait.
Your sister, but didn't you say she was your lover?
Whatever is the matter.
It is not that difficult. My sister is my lover.
But is she really your sister if she's in you? Like, what?
I loved her so deeply. And she loved me so deeply.
What the hell?
The fact that we were
no physical connection.
Why does it say
us?
That?
I guess they made no physical connection there, is what they're trying to tell us.
Okay.
Just so everyone knows, there's not anything going on right there, right now.
They called it forbidden love.
This is pretty funny they put that there.
Could stop the love we shared.
I guess for the reading.
Just so everyone knows, there's no copulation going on right now. They're just hugging really closely.
Oh, how I long for my sister's warmth. The only time I felt at peace.
It's such a great wording, too.
I was enveloped in my sister's warmth. For my beloved sister.
Of course, I think the funniest thing about this is the rating is still M after all, anyway.
Maybe in Japan it's different.
I don't know. I thought that was the way for every region, because people made a point of saying that the pink blood was initially to try to reduce the rating getting bumped up, but it did get bumped up anyway.
Oh.
But they just kept it for stylish reasons. I don't know about this game, though.
Or also, I know that like Japan really started cracking down on like child pornography in thing, like in manga and stuff, so if he's underage, they might have also done it.
Oh, because he might look questionable?
Yeah.
Even though they usually are supposed to be over 18, because they've been like mind wiped to be older than they're supposed to be.
Or how old he was when she died.
Well, anyway.
Anyway, moving on.
Yeah, this is already disturbing. Let's move on. Not his wife and my beloved sister. I had to.
Always messing around.
You had to escape from here, right?
No,
I had to kill for her.
Huh?
Oh,
what?
I'm right.
Sister.
Wait, was he trying to do her in the seance and not Angie?
Maybe. I don't know. She was always in and out of the hospital ever since she was a child. Because of that, she didn't have many friends. She always seemed so lonely.
However,
even if I could be her little brother and her lover, I couldn't be her friend. So I thought I'd find her some friends. Friends for my dear deceased sister.
Huh?
Oh, I see. Deceased.
Do you understand?
My sister is now a ghost. So her friend should be ghost too.
Wait,
right?
Does that mean that he's killed 100, almost 100 people?
Yeah, that means he's been murdering quite a bit, I suppose. He didn't say the exact number.
For my beloved sister.
For sister's sake, I've killed many to send her 100 friends. They were all wonderful people. Worthy of being sister's friends. Huh? What?
But like, what if you had accidentally killed Kokichi? Or not accidentally, but like, what if Kokichi had gone in there? You would have sent him to be friends with your sister?
Maybe then he wouldn't have let him die. He'd be like, I'll hold off for now. This is too impossible to understand. Too impossible.
Sister.
Sister is very happy.
Yes.
Yes, Korakayo, I am very happy. Thanks to you, I am not lonely.
What?
I don't know what it should be doing for that.
Could it be that the lipstick version of Kyo is...
I am Korekyo's older sister.
Thank you for looking after my little brother.
What?
What the hell?
Yes.
After I lost my beloved sister, I was so distraught, I nearly went mad.
Nearly.
Nearly. That's a good thing you didn't go completely off the deep end. Obviously. But sister came to save me.
I am pleased.
She visited me during one of my seances and stayed inside me.
Sister...
Now I can see her whenever I want. I'm never lonely.
Korekyo.
That's wonderful, Korekyo. Your love made the impossible possible.
Are you serious?
Are you serious? Is this really a spirit?
I told you.
He's just delusional.
What a sad girl who can't even believe in the power of love.
Ew.
Either way, he's totally out of his mind. I mean, he killed for a dead chick.
You said you killed a lot already, right? So it wasn't just the two you killed here.
What was that?
What?
Seems like he was already crazy before he got here.
Because?
You didn't kill to escape from here. That wasn't your purpose from the get-go. You just wanted to slaughter a bunch, huh?
Unacceptable.
Do not make me out to be some bloodthirsty, indiscriminate killer. I only kill girls who I think are worthy of being sister's friends.
But well, Angie wasn't planned, and Tenko was random.
Yeah, I guess you just got lucky at the way it worked out.
Huh?
It's an awful big coincidence. Only girls. I see. Wait, I think he did say the medium should be a girl. Maybe he did that, right? Well, I guess we'll see soon. So we were deciding who should be the medium. Yeah, there.
Okay.
Before that, let's choose a spiritual medium. It would work best with a girl.
Aha. Now we see. You said it would work best with a girl.
I spent my time evaluating all the girls here.
Wonderful.
And besides Maki and Miyu, they were all worthy. All worthy of being sister's friends.
All worthy?
Why, you?
Hey, how come I'm not included? I mean, not like I care.
Then
the second victim could have been me.
It could have been Himiko. It was close.
Tenko died in place of me. Then I'll do it. I can't think of oops, that's still her. I can't think of anyone but me that Angie's spirit should go in. No, I'll do it.
Excellent.
Himiko would have been great, but Tenko volunteering made me so happy. Her noble, earnest heart made her a perfect friend for sister.
Wonderful.
She even infiltrated the student council to protect Himiko.
Huh?
Infiltrate? Really?
But
how did you... It was obvious to me. I have studied many people.
Can this be?
Yes, she stood up against the darkness of the school all by herself. All for her beloved friend.
Beautiful.
I was so touched by that. Wonderful. She was a perfect friend for sister. I can't understand why you didn't like her, Himiko.
Aw.
Well.
Though, I was planning on having you become sister's friend too. Eventually.
No way!
What? You do all that for?
Wow.
You did all that just to kill. For you to go that far, that's pretty impressive.
Oh, no.
You were interested in the caged child, just so you could use it to kill someone, right? It interested me as an anthropologist, of course. But more than that...
For my beloved sister!
I wanted to kill for sister. I cannot deny that overpowering feeling.
Now Kaido's all sweaty again.
Are you okay?
Kaido, are you okay? You're looking kind of pale.
Don't worry about it. Let's just focus on Kyo right now. Allow me to explain, though. I did not plan to kill both of them.
Yeah, we know. You said this already.
I knew I would have plenty of chances after escaping this place.
However.
But Angie walked in on me preparing, and I ended up killing her a different way. So I figured, I may as well kill someone else too. After all, it would be a shame to just waste the seance trick I had prepared.
What is that?
You're talking like you killed her just because you could.
That's pretty much why.
No. Not just because I could. I was sending another friend to sister.
Korikyo.
Oh, Korikyo, you're such a thoughtful little brother. It was so bad to get so greedy.
Oh dear.
You're right. Because of that, now I can't send 100 friends to sister.
Do you understand now? Those were the circumstances of Korikyo's crime.
I do not understand. That is all too impossible for me to understand.
Why?
That's right. Killing two friends for your dead sister?
But how?
That's wrong. That's so wrong. Oh, don't get so worked up. There's something I learned after sister's death.
Do not worry.
Death only changes a person's form. The soul lives on as a ghost.
That's right.
That's right. Even though I'm a ghost now, I am always by Korikyo's side.
Sister.
Ah, thank you, sister. I love you.
Cut it out already.
What was that?
I don't understand anything you're saying. Nothing is making sense. It's not fair. Why did Angie and Tenko have to die for something so unfair?
Yeah, it's such a shame.
Because death is unfair.
Yeah. And another thing.
All deaths are unfair deaths. Why do you think news stations get such high ratings when they're reporting about death? Because everyone likes unfair deaths.
Maybe.
Well, if you look at it like that, this whole killing game embodies that philosophy, right? Gifted high school students forced to play a killing game. Man, if people were watching this, they would get a kick out of it. If people were watching this...
Shut up!
Knock off the bullshit. Only sick fucks would enjoy watching this.
You got me!
Oh no. Hell yeah. If I wasn't in this killing game, I would have so much fun watching.
So then...
The nature of this killing game is yet shrouded in mystery. But my role in it is over. I have finished my explanation to you. Friends.
Sister.
I think I shall go and see her now. My beloved sister.
Sister.
I was unable to send her 100 friends, but at least I can see her again now.
Korakio.
Ah, it's all right, sweet Korakio. Come to me.
Oh.
Looks like you're already prepared. Now then, let's get started.
It's punishment time!
The moment you've all been waiting for.
Huh?
Punishment time?
Sister.
My beloved sister. At long last, I'll finally get to see you again.
That's right.
Yes, from now on, no one will try to stop us. We can be together without having to hide our love from others.
What?
Wait, I can't accept this.
Therefore.
Like I said, there's no such thing as a death that can be accepted.
From an anthropological point of view.
Why do you think so many different cultures have funeral rites? Why do you think rumors of ways to resurrect the dead never cease?
Yes.
The living must find a reason, however forced, to accept death when it happens. How you come to terms with death also determines how you live, yes?
What was that?
What?
That was the answer I reached. How about you? How will you live a life that faces death?
Now then, I've prepared a very special punishment.
For the ultimate anthropologist, Korakio Shinguji.
How do you say that?
Shinguji.
Korakio Shinguji.
I shall observe.
I will watch over you all as a ghost. As your friend, I will watch over you. How heartening.
That's right.
It won't be just me and Korakio. All those who died will be watching. I'll be watching to see how you face the death of your friends.
Humanity is beautiful.
I'll be watching forever and ever and ever.
It's punishment time!
Let's give it everything we got. Poor Kaito. Still suffering. Whoa, fancy. Later.
What was that sound?
I don't know. Wow, this is fancy. Oh no! The two Mono Cubs. They're right nearby a very dangerous area.
But what about Mono Dan?
Yeah, what about him?
Oh, there
he is.
There?
Oh no.
Oh, is he gonna get offed now?
I don't know. I'm worried. Are they plotting against him?
Maybe.
Whoa, this is a really complicated one. Yeah, Mono Dan just seems to be watching.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Wait, he's committing suicide.
Oh no. How sad. Ugh. This is creepy looking. Uh-oh, wait. Oh, Monokuma's putting an end to this. Salt! So much salt.
Wow.
Well, I guess so much for that idea. But what about Mono Dam?
I guess he's gone.
That's sad.
What?
Oh, Gory!
No! None of them! Why?
How can this be?
What the? To think my cute child would commit suicide?
Yay!
No, it's so cute! It's so freaking cute that he would kill himself because he couldn't get along.
Wow, Monokuma, you're a real bastard.
Monokuma committed suicide. Had I known this would happen, I would have been nicer to him.
Yeah, sure you would have.
The only reason Monokuma obsessed over getting along was because everyone but me bullied him.
That's right.
Yes, the other Monokubs drove him to suicide, but not me.
There are only two of you left besides him.
I know.
Hey, so who's Monodam?
Eh? Huh? You already forgot. That's kind of scary.
Well now.
Well, looks like another class trial is wrapped up without incident. So,
you call it without incident, huh?
I'm just gonna take back here this little Necronomicon. Seems like a waste, though. You guys sure you don't want to use it? You guys should have brought someone back to life and added them to your roster.
You?
Shut up! How long are you gonna keep talking about that?
I told you.
Ignore him. The whole resurrection ritual is obviously a lie. He's just trying to shake us mentally to get us to panic.
What's the point?
I'm assuming you'll think another murder will happen if you do that, right?
Who can say?
What a waste! If none of you are gonna use it, you should have let me have it. Then I could have resurrected one of my dead siblings.
Which one?
Well, I don't know. They were all pretty terrible, actually.
What about Monodam? You're just feeling bad for her.
Oh, wait, did one of us die? I could have sworn it's just been the two of us the whole time.
Oh, yeah.
It's too bad you missed your chance to raise the dead. That's what you get for doubting me. Too bad.
So long, farewell. And now there's only two. Even now he still talks about raising the dead.
Always messing around.
Man, this is stupid. What people believe in is up to them, but living people shouldn't have to suffer because of the dead.
Of course!
The living are more precious than the dead, no matter what.
That's not something a coward like you should say.
Shut up. Leave me alone.
But there's one thing this case taught me. I thought there was a god watching over us, but there isn't after all, not in this academy.
Yeah, you're right.
You're right.
Well, that's why we have to work together, right? Face it together. Our ultimate talents are the best weapons we have.
Going to do his best.
Then going to do his best to keep everyone safe. Going to want to protect everyone.
But your talent is entomology.
He's also super strong.
I don't want Shuichi to use his ultimate talent anymore. I'm getting sick of class trials.
Aww.
You're right.
Hey, your talent as an assassin is way more trouble. When are you gonna use that, huh?
Okay.
I'll work hard until everyone trusts my ultimate talent.
Huh?
That's right.
It may not be possible now, but I'll put in the effort so everyone can trust me. I won't run away anymore. I want to survive and escape this place with everyone.
Maki. I see. I wonder how long that'll last. What if your true calling as a killer shows? Make sure you use it against Monokuma. Don't underestimate her. Maki rolls one of my sidekicks.
Got a minute?
I don't remember being your sidekick. Also, didn't I tell you to stop calling me Maki Roll?
Just once or twice. Ah, you guys are so close now. This must be the powerful bond of friendship. But I would have preferred it to happen sooner. Especially not after losing 7 people. You're right. Only 9 people left now.
Well, what do you know? The dumbass can do basic math. That's right, 7 pieces of shit have been flushed away and only 9 remain.
Actually,
by that calculation, doesn't that make you one of the pieces?
Nice shot, Mew. Just 9 of us.
Well, you know.
Humans are like weeds, too numerous to count. 7 of us dead doesn't mean much in the end.
Shit.
That's totally what the Heartless Robot's thinking. Right? Right?
How rude!
No, I am not thinking that. Your blatant robophobia is simply inexcusable.
But you know...
But hey, none of us gave up, right? I know we're all gonna escape. I'm not gonna rely on a god, spirits, or the dead.
I believe in you.
Just you guys. I believe in all of you.
Okay.
Kaito.
Well, of course.
You're right. Those of us who remain can start over.
Hey.
Hold up. Keyboy needs to apologize to everyone for the whole student council thing. And there's only one kind of apology that I'm willing to accept. Wait, why does he have to do it? There were multiple people in there. It's mostly Angie's idea. Yank your head off and smash onto the ground with all your strength. Got that?
No way!
I've never heard of such an intense form of an apology. Seems like everything is settled for now. Even though we're missing her. Aww.
You alright?
Himiko, you okay? Anything Gonta can do to help, you can tell Gonta.
Hey!
I think we should let her have some space for now. That might be for the best. For her.
Okay.
I remember how I felt.
Oh.
Or maybe someone should punch her in the face like Kaito did to us. I don't know. Oh. Gonta understand.
You're so dumb.
God, Himiko is such a liar.
Huh?
What? Why do you have to do this now?
Because I'm a liar.
Personally, I don't think lies are exactly a bad thing. Let's face it, you wouldn't have any free will if the world was comprised with just the truth.
But
even then, I don't think it's good to lie to yourself, you know?
Right? What are you saying? Think about Himiko's feelings a little bit.
Nuh-uh.
I only said this because I thought about it.
Because?
Himiko has been lying to herself about her own feelings, so she's been holding back.
Hey!
Hey, what are you repressing? Why are you trying so hard to hold back? What? Hold back?
Expressing your feelings is perfectly natural. You shouldn't feel ashamed at all. So if you feel like crying while you're talking to Angie, go ahead and cry your eyes out. You'll feel better when you do. Well, I mean, laughing makes you feel better too. And venting your anger onto something can really cheer you up. Train your heart by crying, laughing, and venting your anger, Himiko.
Aw. I was kinda hoping she'd give Kokichi a little bit of a punch to the face, maybe. Show him a thing or two.
Tenko, Angie, I'm so lonely. I'm so lonely without you two. But I gotta survive. I still can't go to where you are. But I'm lonely. I'm so lonely without the both of you.
Himiko.
Damn it.
Himiko cried for a long time. She cried as if she was releasing all the emotions she had bottled up inside. Before we knew it, as if lured by her doing so, we began crying.
Oh my god.
I didn't know she could open her mouth that big. The tears we shed, I can't even describe it. We were crying about what we had been through, what was to come. Sadness, hatred, frustration, discord, anger, love. Tears, filled with emotion. But at the very least, they weren't tears of submission. They were tears to push us forward. After a while, Himiko finally calmed down. However... Aww.
Is she hard to carry, Gonta?
No, she fine.
She's sleeping very peacefully.
She's all tuckered out after crying. Robots sleep well after leaking their oils too, right?
That's not important right now.
I've told you many times that I do not use oil as my fuel source.
But wow, that really surprised me. She passed out as soon as she stopped crying.
Yeah, but she looks so peaceful sleeping like that.
She probably felt better after letting it all out, don't you think?
That would make sense.
Yeah, I hope so.
Then go and tell Carrie Himiko to her room.
What a gentleman.
Make sure you focus real good on your back, you hear me? You'll need that focus if you want to feel her little mosquito bites poking ya!
Mew, really?
There's no way he'd do such a thing. Gonta is a gentleman after all.
He is. A true gentleman, through and through. While we were heading back to the dorms, I suddenly noticed Kaito had stopped in his tracks. What's wrong, Kaito? What's wrong? Nothing. I just wanted to get some night air. Don't worry about me, go on ahead.
Huh?
Are you sure?
Well...
Anyway, don't do something like this again, okay? If you dislike scary things, then you should have said so earlier. I thought you were sick.
You worried about me?
Yeah, worried about your stupidity.
Ha! Still haven't warmed up to me, huh?
But...
Maybe not, but I feel like the walls we had up are coming down a little. You know? Perhaps those walls were her enemies. It seems like she doesn't want to wait anymore.
Got it.
Yeah, because of me.
Okay.
Yeah, maybe, but you sound like you're bragging, Kaito. But like I said, I'm gonna get some fresh air before I go back. You can go on ahead.
Okay.
Sure. Got it. See you tomorrow.
Got it.
Yeah. See you tomorrow. All right. Sounds good, I hope. After a goodbyes, I returned to my dorm. I didn't notice what was going on with Kaito. Oh no. What does that mean? Oh no, he's still sick? What?
Or does he just not want to train?
I don't know.
Oh my god, what?
What the hell, Kaito?
I don't have time to be dying. I still haven't gone into space yet.
Oh no.
Damn it. No way am I gonna die here. No way.
What is it? Does he have some sickness he never told us about?
How can you be an astronaut with a sickness?
I don't know. But that's not good. Oh man, what the hell? Just when we're feeling positive after all that misery.
Oh great, we got the mask.
That creepy mask he was using. Yeah, I guess we'll save now. Before we begin the next chapter. Alright, so... Wow. Yeah, Kyo had quite the crazy story behind him, much like I thought he would. And I guess, next time we'll pick up... Oh, is he gonna play something? Oh no, what's this?
Hey there. Guess I don't have to introduce myself, huh?
Is that Rentaro? Maybe we'll see this, hold on. Keep going for a little bit.
Oh,
what?
Man.
I get that this is probably pretty confusing, seeing yourself like this.
Oh.
Guess I should start from the beginning.
Did he record That's a video to himself?
I
now,
think he
Monokuma
did.
Monokuma probably already told you this, but just in case. This killing game will continue until there are only two people left.
Wait, really? That's different than the other games.
Now the important part of that rule is that... Oh, there is one more.
Of course. The one important thing that we need to know.
Well, the truth is, this isn't your first.
Ah.
Anyone who finds out who you are is going to come for you. So watch your back. Trust me.
So he's been in a killing game before?
Sounds like it. Then again, they did cut out the vital part.
And never forget.
But why else would he record this and know about Monokuma?
That would seem to imply
you wanted
it.
This killing game.
Wait, you wanted
you
it?
Win, no matter what.
So they did volunteer for this?
No matter what.
What in the world?
Or at least he wanted it. Remember I said it was kind of like a Hunger Games
That's
thing?
That's an interesting part to leave
my
off on.
Guess? Oh. What?
Alright, well, I'll leave off here before we go any further. But jeez, how crazy is that? Alright, everyone. Well, even more stuff for us to mull over for next time. But yeah, that'll be all. So thanks for watching, everyone. Take care and bear well.